Good morning, students. My name is Poonam Daswani. I hope you all are good and your family is doing great. Students, today we will be starting with the math lesson 3. Today we will be starting with the math lesson 3. Name of the chapter is subtraction. Name of the chapter is subtraction. In the previous lecture, we finished with the lesson 2 addition. Now we will be moving on to the lesson 3 subtraction. Students, I want you all to open your textbook and your notebook. Textbook page number 31. I look back. This is the warm-up exercise. Now, what is the warm-up exercise? Help the bear to find the way to his house by solving the subtraction sums given below and coloring the respective answers in the given grid. What is the question given? Help the bear to find the way to his house by solving the subtraction sums given below and coloring the respective answers in the given grid. So what you have to do? You have to subtract the sums and find the way of the bear. Now we will solve the sums. Students, this is the way how you are going to solve the sums. How you will solve the sums? You will subtract the sums. And after subtraction, what we have to do? We have to help the bear find its way. Now, what you will do after solving the sums? What we will do? We will color the boxes with the similar color in the where the answer is there. What we will do? First, we will subtract the sums. We will find the answers. When you subtract 42 minus 5, you get 37. When you subtract 24 minus 9, you get 15. When you subtract 89 minus 20, you get 69. When you subtract 55 minus 16, you get 39. What we have to do? We have to do the subtraction sums. Means we have to remove, we have to take out the numbers. We have to remove the smaller numbers from the bigger numbers. We have to take it out. We have to remove the numbers. So, this is the way when you solve the sums, you get the answers when you subtract. After that, what we have to do? We have to help the bear to find its way to its house. Now, what we will do after solving the sums? You will color the boxes. See, is it fun doing color the boxes? Yes. You feel nice when you color, na? So find the correct answers and color the boxes. The first answer is 37. So I have colored both the boxes in the pink color, that is same color. The second answer is 15. I have colored both the boxes in green color. After that, the answer for C is 69. I have colored both the boxes in yellow. Then 39. I have colored both the boxes in blue color. Then 35 is red color. 17 is again in blue color, but it is a light blue color. Then 88 minus 35 is 53. 90 minus 46 is 44. I have colored it in a same color. Then 29 in yellow. 97 minus 8 is, what is the answer? 89. Again, I have colored 89 in brown color. 78 minus 42 is 36. I have colored it in the pink color. So this is the way, then you will draw the line and show the bear, help the bear to reach its home. So this is the way you are going to do this exercise, the warm-up exercise. This warm-up exercise we are not going to solve in the notebook. We will only solve this warm-up exercise in the textbook. Only in the textbook. No solving in the notebook. Okay. Now we move on to the first exercise. That is my practice time 1. My practice time 1. So I want you all to open your notebook also and open textbook page number 33. Open textbook page number 33. My practice time 1, question 1 is subtract. As you can see, there are boxes, columns given in the textbook and the numbers are placed in the correct columns. So what we will do? We will directly subtract the sums. Now as we subtract vertically in a standing line, first we will subtract the numbers on the ones place. We always subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. We always subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. Okay. So, which is the bigger number given? 456 minus 3. Now, the number on the ones place is 6 minus 3. 6 minus 3. So how you will count 6 minus 3? What will you do? How you will subtract? What you have to do? You have to take 6 fingers. What you will do? You will take 6 fingers. Now how many you have to remove? What is the number in the second column? You have to remove 3 numbers. So you will remove 3. 1, 2, 3. Now from 6 we removed 3. So what is the answer? How many fingers are remaining? 1, 2, 3. So the answer is 3. And 5 minus 0 means nothing. So 5 will remain as it is. So 5 minus 0 is 5. So 5 will come down as it is. And 4 minus 0. Excuse me. 4 minus 0 means there is no number in the below column. So 4 minus 0 is 4. So the answer is 453. Now we move on to the C sum. The B sum is for the homework. So we move on to the C sum. What are the numbers on the C sum? 698 minus 52. So we subtract vertically in a standing line. So what we will do? We will subtract the numbers on the ones place, then tens place, then hundred place. So what are the numbers on the ones place? As we subtract smaller number from the bigger number, what are the numbers? 8 minus 2. So you always take the fingers which are of bigger number. So what is the bigger number? 8. How many fingers you will take? 8. How many you have to remove? You have to remove 2. So what you will do? 1 and 2. Now how many fingers are remaining? Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. How much is remaining? How many fingers are remaining? 6 fingers. So what you will write? 8 minus 2 is 6. Now what are the numbers on the tens place? Numbers on the tens place. 9 minus 5. We have to remove 5 from the number 9. Means we will subtract 5 from 9. So we will take 9 fingers. How many fingers we will take? 9 fingers. How many fingers we will remove? What is the number in the other column? The number on the tens place in the second column is 5. So we have to remove 5. We will subtract 5. Now we removed 5 number. How many fingers are remaining now? Count 1, 2, 3, 4. The fingers remaining are 4. So 9 minus 5 is 4. And below 6 there is no number. So we consider it as 6. 6 minus 0 is 6. So the answer is 646. 646. Here are the answers, students. You can write it. The D sum is also for the homework. You can copy the answers. Or you can solve it on your own. The D sum is for the homework. Now we move on to the E sum. This is the way how you will solve the sums in the textbook. Now we move on to the E sum. What is the E sum? 651 minus 450. So what you will do? 1 minus 0. First we minus numbers on the ones place, then tens place, then hundred place. The numbers on the ones place are 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0. 0 means nothing. So how much is remaining? 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. And 5. Another number is 5 minus 5. Now we take 5 fingers. And how much we have to remove? We have to remove 5. So 5 minus 5. 5 removed. Now what are the fingers remaining? Are there any fingers remaining? No. So 5 minus 5 is 0. And the numbers on the hundred place are 6 minus 4. So we take 6 fingers. And how many fingers we have to remove? We have to remove 4 fingers. So remove 4 fingers now. 6 minus 4. So we will remove 4 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now how many fingers are remaining? Count. How many fingers are remaining? 1 and 2. So 6 minus 4 is 2. So the answer is 201. Alright. Now the F sum is for the homework. We move on to the G sum. What are the numbers on the G sum? 698 minus 298. 252. So what we will do? We subtract the numbers vertically in a standing line. So first we will subtract the numbers on the ones place, then tens place, then hundred place. So what are the numbers on the ones place? 8 minus 2. We always take the fingers that is of the bigger number. So you take 8 fingers. Now how many fingers you have to remove? 2 fingers. You have to remove 2. 8 minus 2. So 1 and 2. So how many fingers are remaining? Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many fingers are remaining? 6 fingers. So 8 minus 2 is 6. Now what is the another number? 9 minus 5. 9 minus 5. So we have to remove 5 from 9. So remove 5. What is the answer? How many fingers are remaining? 4 fingers. So 9 minus 5 is 4. Now the next number is 6 minus 2. So how many fingers you will take? 6 fingers. How many you have to remove? 2 fingers. So 1 and 2. You remove 2 fingers. Now how many fingers are remaining? 4 fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the answer is 446. Here are the I will show you the answers. Just a second. Okay students, so here are the answers. The answer for the E sum, the answer for the F sum, answer for the G sum, and the answer for the H sum. Now what we have to do, we have to solve these same sums in the notebook as well. We have to solve the sums in the notebook. So I want you all to remove your notebook and open new page. Open new page. What you will write? You will write lesson number 3, my practice time 1. You will not solve the warm-up exercise in the notebook. No. You will start from my practice time 1 in the CW on new page. And what you will do? You will put today's date. What is today's date? Today's date is 31-7-20. Today's date is 31-7-20. Write lesson 3, subtraction. What is the name of the chapter? Subtraction. Students, many of you pronounce the subtraction in a wrong way. It is not subtraction. No, it is subtraction. The pronunciation is subtraction. It is not subtraction. No, it is subtraction. The name of the chapter is subtraction. My practice time 1. My practice time 1. Copy question number 1. Subtract. What you have to write? Subtract question number 1. Now I will show you how to solve the sum. Then you solve in the notebook also. Okay? Students, this is the way how you are going to write the date 31, big line 7, big line 20, lesson 3, subtraction. Question 1, subtract. What is the question 1? Subtract. A sum, you will copy the sum. 100 tens ones, you will make the columns. Now you can see in the textbook, there is no column left for the borrow or carry forward of the numbers. But while solving in the notebook, we will leave the one column. In addition, we used to leave for the carry forward. But in the subtraction, we leave for the borrowing of the numbers. We borrow the numbers. We do not carry forward. We borrow the numbers in the subtraction. And in addition, we carry forward. Why? Because we are adding. And in subtraction, we are removing the numbers. So we will borrow the numbers. That you will see in the second question, how we borrow the numbers. So this is the first sum you have to solve. You will write the numbers in the correct columns. 6 minus 3 is 3. This 5 will come as it is. And the 4 will also come down as it is. The answer is 453. You can also copy the answer from the textbook. Now we move on to the C sum. What is the question for the C sum? First write the places, 100 tens ones. Leave the first column. Write the question, 698. Don't forget to put the sign. What is the another number given? 52. Now draw the columns. What you will do? You will write the numbers in the columns and draw the columns in this manner. Don't forget to put the sign. Which sign is this? Subtraction. Now what we will do? First we'll subtract the numbers on the ones place. What are the numbers on the ones place? 8 minus 2. How much is 8 minus 2? 6. When you subtract 8 minus 2, you get 6. 9 minus 5, you get 4. This 6 will come down as it is because here there is no number. So 6 minus 0 is 6. So the answer is 646. Now we move on to the E sum. The D sum is for the homework. So what is the question for the E sum? The question for the E sum is 651 minus 450. 651 minus 450. Don't forget to put the sign. When you put the sign, you know you have to add, you have to subtract, you have to multiply or divide. So the sign is very important. One child asked me that whenever she or he does the sums at home, whenever she does the sums at home, what happens? When she solves the sums at home, the sums answers are always wrong. She solves the sums in the wrong manner. So, because she doesn't see the sign, which sign is given. So, the sign is very important. Don't forget to put the sign. Now, 1 minus 0 is 1. 5 minus 5 is 0. 6 minus 4 is 2. So the answer is 201. Now similarly with the F, we move on to the G sum. The sum is similar. First column we leave for the borrowing of the numbers. 698 minus, the sign is minus. Minus 252. Now we have to subtract 8 minus 2, 9 minus 4, 6 minus 2. Means we will remove 2 from 8, we remove 5 from 9, and we remove 2 from 6. So when you remove 2 from 8, you get 6. When you remove 5 from 9, means 9 minus 5 is 4. 6 minus 2 is 4. So the answer is 446. Students, this is the way you are going to solve the sums in the notebook. You can also copy the sums from the video, but if you solve the sums on your own, it will be easy for you to understand. So this is the way you are going to write lesson 3, subtraction, my practice time 1. Question 1, subtract. A sum, B sum, C, D, E, F, G, H. These all sums will fit on the one page, but do the sums neatly and correctly. The sums B, D, F and H are for the homework. So we stop here with the subtraction question 1. The other questions, that are question 2, 3 and 4, we will solve in the next lecture. Students, I hope you have understood the sums. If you have any doubts or queries, you can mail it on my mail ID. Thank you for listening to the lecture. Students, thank you so much.